بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Today إن شاء الله تعالى we'll be giving away lots of prizes. The real prizes will be on the 28th إن شاء الله. But today I'll be giving away a lot of sisters. Sister Faiza, please. I gave you a bunch of very nice hijabs, giveaway for the sisters, hijabs, and I have an Eid gift today for somebody who's going to wear it. I have a brand new Eid Shalwar Qamis. Somebody gave it to me, and I want to practice the ayah, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا تَنَالُ الْقِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُ مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. Allah says, you shall not gain bill until you give from that which you love. I love my clothes, but I'm going to give it away. Somebody gave this to me, brand new Shalwar Qamis for Eid. Right? I'm going to give it away. This is custom made, by the way. All the way from the land, green and white.
Pakistan.
Inshallah. All right. So,
what size?
Pay attention, inshallah. Even the Arabs can wear this. I wear this all the time. This is very comfortable. So, here. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. We're going to start with Surah Al-Jum'ah. Huh. I want to give this away. This is just tickling me. I want to give it away. Who can tell me, either brother or sister, Surah Al-Jum'ah, why? There was only one reason why it was revealed. What is the reason why Surah Al-Jum'ah was revealed? If you don't know the answer, don't raise your hand. Only if you know the answer. Why it was revealed. The sabab, the reason why Surah Al-Jum'ah was revealed. Do you know the answer, Akhi? Bismillah.
Yeah. And it was a prayer time, and they had this amusers.
Amusers. All right, stay there. Who can tell me? You're almost, but it's not amusers, and it's not other, but somebody else. Wa alaikum salam. So what kind of prayer?
That is Jum'ah prayer.
Oh, it was Jum'ah. So you missed that. It was Jum'ah, and the Prophet was not praying. He was giving the sermon. Just like me, I'm giving the sermon, and some people stand and they go for tea. Right? And then Allah revealed. When He tell them, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَإِذَا رَأَوْ تِجَارَةً أَوْ لَهْوًا انْفَضُّوا وَتَرَكُوكَ قَائِمًا. They, when they see some amusement, some tijara, there was a convoy, some people, they came to Medina with like a lot of camels carrying lots of food, and then the Prophet is giving the khutbah, just like here, I'm talking and talking, and then they just stood up and left the Prophet, just let them be talking, and they went for whatever they went there for, and then they left the Prophet talking, you know, so it was during Jum'ah, so Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed. So she was right, you were right, I'll give you the shalwar, she gets the qamis. I don't know how to do this. Sister, you're right. Sister, give her hijab. Give her hijab, I'll give you this. I'll give you this. Yeah, it will say, inshallah. So this is for Eid, huh? Inshallah. All right. Who knew the answer? Here. Who knew the answer? You're the mission, can't lie. It's only chocolate. Who knew the answer? All right, bismillah. Who knew the answer? Here we go. طيب, this is in Surah Al-Jum'ah, it's a Madani Surah, right? It's a Madani, of course, because it happened in Medina. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now is Surah Al-Munafiqun, the hypocrites. Surah Al-Jum'ah, Surah Al-Munafiqun, it's also a Madani Surah, the hypocrites. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the ayah, the sign of the hypocrites are three, or four. In one hadith is three, in one another narration is four. He says, إِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذَا. When he speaks, he lies. This is one of the signs of the hypocrites. When he speaks, he lies. When he makes a promise, he breaks his promise. وَإِذَا أَتُمِنَ خَانَ. When he makes a promise, he breaks his promise. This is one of the signs of the hypocrites. And the Prophet and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the hypocrites will be in the lowest level in hellfire. But there's something interesting about the head of the hypocrites in Medina. His name is Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. There is only one man on earth. Listen to this. This is interesting. There's only one man on earth who happens to be a munafiq. And the Prophet knew he was a munafiq. And the Sahaba, they all knew he was a munafiq. His son was a very righteous, pious Sahabi. But the father was the head of the hypocrites. Only one man on earth who is buried in Medina with the aba'ah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet, he buried him with his kafan. The kafan, يعني the abaya of the Prophet ﷺ, because his son came to Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, give me your abaya. And then the Prophet took the abaya and gave it to him, and then he robbed his father and he buried. This is the head of hypocrites. But he chose the mercy of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Right? Al-Munafiqun. Then Surah Al-Taghabun. Surah Al-Taghabun is a madani surah. Surah Al-Taghabun is a madani surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, verse number 14, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. This is interesting. For those who are married, for those who have kids, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, inna min azwajikum wa awladikum aduwwan lakum fahdharuhum. Allah says, oh you who believe, from your spouses, some of your spouses and children are enemies to you. All right, are enemies to you. What does that mean? Some of my children are enemies to me. My spouses are enemies to me. What does that mean? That enemies to you. How can they be enemies to you? How can your children be your enemies?
They can make you do
how life. Can your son or your wife or your husband, sister, how can he or she be your enemy?
They can make
sister,
you
hold on, hold on. That may be not because they complain. Are you on?
Because distractions.
Because distractions? So distraction, you're my enemy? Give your ibadah. Give al hijab. Give al hijab. Aywa. When they ask you to do something haram and they're your enemy?
Yes.
When na'am, she keeps on bugging you until you maybe you buy a house that's you know, from riba or whatnot. Isn't that an enemy? Na'am. So the Prophet is saying, احذروهم. There are some of your spouses or your children, they can be enemies to you. So be careful. Surah al-Talaq. Amazing. This is one surah talk about divorce. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu idha talaqtumu an-nisaa fatalliquhunna li'iddatihin. Oh, you prophet, when you divorce your women, divorce them li'iddatihin. Li'iddatihin is the waiting period. Okay, it's a question for the sisters now. What is the idda of the mutallaqa? And what is the idda of the one who loses her husband? That means the widow. There are two types of idda here. There are two types of waiting period. The waiting period, if you know the answer, you will get hijab and you will get, Quran.
The idda for mutallaqa is 3 months.
The idda for mutallaqa is how long? How many days?
3 months.
For the mutallaqa, for the divorced one?
Yes.
Okay.
For the widow, it's 4 months.
Give her half hijab. Half. Give her hijab. Who can give me the full correct answer? The widow. One more. What brother? Yalla, Yohwani. 40 days.
4 months, 10 days.
Allah, if you were next to me, I would have kiss you in your head, your bald head. Huh? Who said that? 4 months and 10 days. 4 months and 10 days. How about the idda waiting period for the divorced woman?
Three months and three months recycle. We said it.
We mentioned
for the one divorced is 3 months per cycle, and for the one whose husband passed away, it's 4 months and 10 days.
Okay. And give chocolate, sister, the Lindor chocolate.
Lindor.
Then, when Allah is talking about divorce, He says something interesting. What does Allah say? He says, verse number 2, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ
مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ
وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Right when Allah talks about divorce and He says, and whoever fears Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall provide him from ways and avenues he's never thought of. He's talking about talaq and then he's talking about the fear of Allah azza wa jal. You see the connection right there. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. And whoever fears Allah, Allah is sufficient for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Surah Tahrim. Surah Tahrim is interesting, Surah Tahrim, like making something haram. Why it was revealed? It's interesting. The wives of the Prophet Muhammad, they planned a little plot against Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Who knows the name of the wife that the Prophet Muhammad used to go to and eat honey at?
Zainab.
Sayyidina. There are two Zainabs. Prophet married two Zainabs.
The wife.
But this?
The wife.
Zainab.
Zainab.
Is this a new one? Zainab?
Bint Jahsh.
Bint Jahsh, give her. It is Zainab bint Jahsh. So what happened? Prophet Muhammad used to go to Zainab bint Jahsh. And he used to eat honey from, you know, in her house. Aisha and Hafsa, Zakallah khair. They teamed up. They said, when Prophet Muhammad comes, let's tell him that he smells, you know, this bad smell, this thing like a citrus thing. And then if he goes to your home, you tell him the same thing. And then Prophet Muhammad came to Aisha's house and says, yeah, so I smell al-maghafir. Maghafir is like a plant that's got this weird smell. And then he says, no, I just went to Hafsa's home and I ate honey. And then I went to Zainab's home and I ate honey. And then he went to Hafsa's home. And then Hafsa, she told him the same thing. So the Prophet says, I shall never eat honey again from her home. So they got what they wanted, but Allah revealed, Ya ayyuha al-Nabi, lima tuharrimu ma ahallallahu lak? Oh, you Prophet, why do you make something halal that Allah made halal to make it haram? So they were trying to plot something, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed their plot. That sister, did she answer the question? The one, like I said, I'm going to give up the Quran?
Yeah, she did.
Okay, so I have your Quran, okay, inshallah. The brother will give it, inshallah. Surah al-Mulk also will be covered. 10 minutes. Surah al-Mulk. Al-Mani'ah. Surah Al-Mulk, it's a Mekki surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the days or what happens in the hereafter. Subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the dominion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And by the way, the Prophet Muhammad says, whosoever recites Surah Al-Mulk every night, Surah Al-Mulk will come and accompany you in your grave. Tabarak al-Ladhi biyadihi al-Mulk wa huwa ala. You know, in the grave, you need some companionship. Surah Al-Mulk will come in the form of a person to accompany you in your grave. Recite it, memorize it, inshaAllah ta'ala. Surah Al-Mulk. And then Surah Al-Haqqa, sah? Al-Haqqa, it's a Makki surah. Al-Haqqa. Al-Qalam? You don't do one Al-Qalam? You do one Al-Qalam? Ay, Al-Qalam. Zakallah khair, Zakallah khair. So, Al-Qalam, the pen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the way, the Prophet says, أول ما خلق الله القلم فقال له اكتب قال وما اكتب قال اكتب مقالي إلى يوم القيامة. The Prophet says, the very first thing that Allah created is the pen. And he told the pen to write. The pen said, what shall I write? The pen said, and Allah says, write. Everything is to happen until the end of time. Al-Qalam. We have Surah Al-Qalam. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Qalam, verse number 4, with regard to the Prophet, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Indeed, you are of a great moral character. Al-Khuluq. Brothers and sisters, in this Ramadan, if we don't earn this khuluq, when are we going to, you know, learn it and earn it, you know, and act upon the khuluq of the Prophet Muhammad? Because he says, أَقْرَبُكُمْ إِلَيَّ مَجْلِسَ الْيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَحَاسِلْكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا. Those who will be close to me the day of judgment, those who have good moral characters. Good moral characters, brothers and sisters, is like a smile. No? A smile.
Yeah.
It's a good khuluq, because the Prophet used to have this, you know, smile. They say here, smile is sunnah. Just smile. It's khuluq. And be nice. And then Surah, two more, 1 minute. Al-Haqqa al-Ma'arij. Al-Haqqa al-Ma'arij. Both are Makkiya, whereby Allah Azza wa Jalla talks about the angels. Al-Ruh, fi yawmin kana miqdaruhu 50 alfa sanat. Such a very scary ayah where Allah Azza wa Jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ta'arujul al-Mala'ikatu wal-Ruhu fi yawmin. Allah is talking about that day of judgment, the day of resurrection, where one day will be equivalent to 50,000 years. Everybody is standing, the sun on top of the head, waiting for the hisab. Surah al-Ma'arij. Brothers and sisters, may Allah save us all. Wallah. Today is what? Today is the night of? 25th, which could be what?
Laylatul Qadr.
It could be Laylatul Qadr. We're staying for 20 rak'ah, right? Yeah. All of us. And I'm staying all the way until Fajr. You can make i'tikaf, the new of i'tikaf. The best i'tikaf is 10 days, of course. But you can do part-time i'tikaf. So you can stay with the intention here, praying the whole night until Fajr, inshallah ta'ala. Do that. Barakallahu feekum, zakum Allah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.